Hello guys, my name is Prince and this is Smart Center. Subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos. Post your comments and questions on my social media handles and I'll respond to it. We are still on the topic change of subject. In the previous video, we learned how to change the subject of equation that involves fractions. In this video, we are going to take another question on changing the subject of equations that involve fractions. So let's look at our question for this video. The question is, make y the subject in y minus x divided by v minus x is equal to y over v squared. So we are supposed to make y the subject in this equation. Once again, our equation is y minus x divided by v minus x is equal to y over v squared. As we've been doing in the previous videos, when you have been given an equation with a fraction, the first thing you need to do is to identify your fractions. The fractions in this equation are 1 minus y minus x divided by v minus x and y over v squared. After you've identified the fractions, you will see that the denominators of the fractions are v minus x and v squared, as we have here. Now, as we saw in the previous video, we said that whenever one of the denominators or both of them are fractions, in order to get the LCM, multiply the denominators and use it as fractions. So here, the LCM we are going to use is the product of the denominators, which is v squared times v minus x. So I'm going to write it as v squared into brackets v minus x. So this will be the LCM that we'll be using, v squared into bracket v minus x, or v squared times v minus x. Okay, so after you found that, the next thing that you do is to multiply the LCM with each term in the equation. So this is one term and this is another term. So you multiply the first term by the LCM, which is v squared into bracket v minus x, and you multiply the second term by the LCM, which is v squared into bracket v minus x, as we have here. Now you do the cancellation. We know that v minus x will cancel v minus x, so you have v squared. V squared here will cancel v squared here, so you are going to have v squared times y minus x, so v squared into bracket y minus x. I've explained why we have to put y minus x into bracket, because it's a binomial and it's being multiplied by a single term, which is v squared. Here too, we have v minus x times y. So I'll put v minus x into bracket and y, write y outside the bracket. From here, you open the bracket and you simplify. So we are going to have v squared times y, which will give us v squared y, v squared times x, which will give us minus v squared x, because there's the negative sign there. Y times v will give us yv, then y times x will give us yx. Don't forget the negative sign, so minus yx. Now when you get here, what do you do? Remember that if you want to make a certain variable the subject, you group all the terms with the variables in it on one side. So here we want to make y the subject, so we are going to group all the terms with y in it on one side of the equation. Then we will group the other terms on the other side. So the terms with y in it are y squared, v squared y, yv, and yx. So I'll make sure that all of those terms are on one side of the equation. Then the other term, which is y v squared x, is on the other side of the equation. So I'm going to take yv from this side and bring it over here. I'll take yx from this side and bring it over here. Then I'll send v squared x over there. Okay. So that will give us y squared v squared y minus yv plus yx is equal to v squared x. Remember that when a term crosses the equal to sign, the sign of the number changes. When it's negative, it becomes positive. When it's positive, it becomes negative. From here, our next step is to simplify, is to factorize. So I'm going to factorize out the term you want to make the subject, or the variable you want to make the subject. The variable we want to make the subject is y. So I'm going to take y out and put the rest into brackets. So y, if you take y out, this side becomes v squared, here becomes v, and here becomes x. And this is equal to v squared x. As we've been doing all along, when you get to this stage, you divide through by the term in the bracket or the term attached to the variable you want to make the subject. Here, the variable you want to make the subject is y. The term attached to it is what we have in the bracket, which is v squared minus v plus x. So you divide both sides by v squared minus v plus x. And that is going to give us y into bracket v squared minus v plus x divided by v squared minus v plus x is equal to v squared x divided by v squared minus v plus x. And what do we know from here? We know that this v squared minus v plus x will cancel this v squared minus v plus x because it's the same thing. So y will give us v squared x over v squared minus v plus x. Now someone may ask, why are we not canceling this v squared and this v squared? If you watch the video on division of algebraic expressions, you understand why you don't have to cancel this v squared and v squared. So I would advise that you watch that video and you get clear understanding as to why we are not doing this cancellation. Thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. In the next video, we are going to take another question on changing the subject of equations that involves fractions. Bye-bye.